Yeah, good day everybody. Welcome back to the online classes on this 18 CV 42 module 5. We are discussing about the analysis of cables. Now let us see the last topic on this cables. When stiffening truss is provided below the cables, it is nothing but stiffening trusses for suspension cables. This is the suspension cable, and this is the stiffening truss, or it may be heavy beam. Suspension cables stiffened with a 3-inch girder. This is called the girder. Girder may be heavy beam, as I told, or it may be a truss like this. It may be a truss also like this. This is the stiffening girder. It may be truss or heavy beam. Cable and girder, this cable and the girder are connected by number of suspenders. This is an elevation. Since the suspenders are very large, due to the load acting on the girder, will be transferred to cable in the form of UDL. That is WE per meter. These external loads will be transferred to cable in the form of equivalent UDL, because there are large number of suspenders. Therefore, here we have to deal the analysis of this stiffening truss or heavy girder and the analysis of the arch. Sorry, analysis of the cable. First, we should analyze the girder. Girder is subjected to external loads. Because of that, there will be reactions. That is due to external loads. Loads are acting downward, therefore reaction will be upward. That is like this due to given loading. External loading W1, W2 or W per meter length, if UDL is also acting, reactions will be developed at the end support, let they are RA dash and RB dash. As I told, this external load will transfer to cable as like equivalent UDL, as there are number of suspenders, that is WE per meter length. Therefore, if you consider the load which is acting in this direction on the girder, the analysis should be done by considering equivalent UDL acting upward on the girder, that is due to WE. As load is acting upward in the form of UDL, The reactions developed will be downward. Let they are Ra double dash and Rb double dash. Remember, girder will be analyzed for given loading. That is the first part. Given loading on the girder will be acting down. Therefore, reactions Ra dash and Rb dash developed at A and B will be upward. These external loading will be converted to UDL because these are the loads of the suspenders. As they are very large in number, that will be acting as like an UDL. Let it is W per meter length. And due to this, this UDL is pulling the girder up. Therefore, reactions will be down. Let they are Ra double dash and Rb double dash. This is the free body diagram of the girder for external loading and for equivalent UDL, which is acting up on the girder, and in turn it will be transferred to the cable. This free body diagram we should write carefully. Now, coming to the analysis. If you consider this free body diagram, by applying sigma Fy is equal to 0 and sigma Ma is equal to 0, that is for given loading. Simple. Ra dash and Rb dash can be found. You can take moment about A or about B also, no problem. Simple, very simple support reaction problem. Ra dash and Rb dash can be formed. Coming to due to this equivalent UDL, reactions are downward, UDL is upward. And this Ra double dash and Rb double dash also can be found by applying equilibrium condition. Ra double dash is equal to Rb double dash because of the symmetry will be equal to total load divided by 2, that is WE into L is the total load. That total load will transfer to this and this equally, that means by 2. That means Ra double dash, Rb double dash, we will be finding in terms of WE only because that is unknown still. Now this girder will be statically determined by providing the middle inch, that is sigma MC is equal to 0. That is some here. That is there is a C. That is the inch in the girder. That is sigma MC is equal to 0. If you are applying sigma MC is equal to 0, we should consider either to the left or to the right side. This arrow mark indicates. Any one side only you should consider because we have seen that in arches, 300 arches. Either to the left or to the right of point C, middle inch. If you apply sigma MC is equal to 0, that means it is for given loading and this. Because girder is, we have written two figures. Actually, girder is subjected to this applied external load, given loading, and that will be converted to this UDL because of the suspenders. Therefore, if you are applying sigma MC is equal to 0, you should consider left side or right side depending upon the convenient. But this condition should be for given loading and WE, that is effective. That means if you take ERMC is equal to 0 if you are considering left side. RA dash into its distance to C, WO1 into its distance to C. And RA double dash into its distance to the middle edge, and this UDL into its distance to the middle edge. RA double dash is also in terms of WE, and this UDL is also in terms of WE. Therefore, if you consider the whole thing, the only unknown is WE, and that can be found. Hope you are clear. Analysis of girder and analysis of girder due to given loading and girder due to this equivalent UDL acting upward. That is, by applying these condition, equivalent upward UDL can be found. That is nothing but the load which is acting on the cable. That analysis of the cable will come to later. Now, because this is a heavy girder or a truss, as a whole, there will be bending moment and there will be shear force at every section. Therefore, in cable, bending moment will be zero because of its shape. It will adjust its shape, bending moment will become zero at every section. But here, it is a stiffened girder or heavy beam. Therefore, this should be analyzed as like a beam. Therefore, if you want to calculate bending moment at any section, no, you should deal this and this together. For finding, for easy analysis, we are written two figures separately. But these are all the loads acting on the girder together. Therefore, bending moment at any section, if you want to calculate, by the definition, bending moment at any section in a beam is the algebraic sum of the moments either to the left side or right side of the point or section considered. Therefore, if you consider any section here, to the left of this section, RA dash is responsible for the bending moment, WO1 is responsible for the bending moment, that is due to given loading. Again, at the same section X, RA double dash is responsible, and this length of the UDL up to section XX is responsible for the bending moment. Therefore, bending moment at any section should be bending moment at the section due to given loading plus bending moment due to this equivalent UDL and the respective reaction also. Similarly, shear force at any section or point is the algebraic sum of the forces either to the left or right of the point or section considered. Therefore, shear force can be calculated at any section by taking the algebraic sum of RA dash and WO1. If section is here, that is due to given loading, also due to the equivalent UDL, that is RA double dash and WE converted to equivalent point load up to the section will cause the shear force, that is shear force due to WE also. That is the analysis of the girder. Actually, this type of problem consisting of two parts, analysis of the girder and analysis of the cable. Hope you understood the analysis of the girder. It is like a beam, but it is subjected to downward given loading and upward equivalent UDL. This is the extra thing in this stiffening trusses for suspension cable. Now, the analysis of cable is same as like previous problems, but by taking UDL, equivalent UDL, meter length, that is as UDL. That is this one. Or in this diagram, this WE will go for this cable, that is for equilibrium. Our free body diagram, if you draw, this UDL will be like this, WE. Okay, this analysis of the cable, it is as simple as we have seen, that is reactions here, horizontal and vertical, here, by applying sigma f, x is equal to 0, HA is equal to HB, let it is H, and this is vertical reaction VA and vertical reaction VB, A and B. There are 1, 2, 3 unknowns. Therefore, by considering sigma fx is equal to 0, sigma fy is equal to 0, and sigma m about a or b is equal to 0, we can find the support reaction. Then it comes maximum tension. It will be here like this, tension T, because vertical reaction is more at this support. T will be equal to h squared plus va squared under square root. And further, if it is cable is anchored like this, passing over a pulley, etc., that also can be analyzed. That cable analysis will be seen. We will see that in the numerical problem. That is, analysis of the girder is the extra thing here. We should be careful while dealing this girder, same span, but due to given loading and due to equivalent UDL. That is, a written analysis of cable is same as the previous problem, but by taking equivalent UDL, WO per meter as UDL. Now we'll deal some problems. First problem, a 3-inch stiffening girder, this girder, or it will be this girder, 3-inch. Here center, and here also there will be 1 inch. This is hinge and this is hinge. They explained about the girder here. This was not there in the previous problems. A 3-inch stiffening girder of a suspension bridge of span 100 meter is subjected to 2-point loads, 200 kilonewton and 300 kilonewton, at a distance of 25 meter and 50 meter from left end. 200 kilonewton is at 25 meter, this 300 kilonewton is at another 25 meter or 50 from this, that means almost at the mid span from the left end. Find the shear force and bending moment for the girder at a distance of 30 meters of area. They ask you to find the shear force and bending moment. That is the analysis of the girder from the left end. The supporting cable has a central dip of 10 meter levels. These are at same level, fine. Find also the maximum tension and its slopes, slope on the cable. That we will deal. That is, this part is the analysis of the cable. That we will deal later. Now, if this cable is supported like this and connected to stiffening girder, if you draw free body diagram of the girder and the cable, girder will be subjected to external loads and let the reactions are Ra dash and Rb dash, and an UDL in the upward direction. This will try to pull it up. Therefore, UDL on the girder will be in the upward direction, and let the reactions are downward because UDL is upward. They are Ra double dash and Rb double dash. Here everything is written together. Now, to analyze the girder, I'll come here. This is the free body diagram of the girder. This is the girder. Two loads are acting, 200 kilonewton and 300 kilonewton. Let Ra dash and Rb dash are the reactions. These loads will be transferred to the cable through suspenders like UDL. Let the intensity of UDL is W per meter. UDL is acting up, therefore girder should develop a reaction downward for equilibrium. Let the magnitudes are Ra double dash and Rb double dash. Now, if you consider for the given loading, sigma Fy, if you apply, sigma Fy is equal to 0, C plus Ra dash plus Rb dash upward forces will be equal to downward forces, that is 200 kilonewton and 300 kilonewton, totally 500. Call this equation number 1. Now again, for the given loading, let us apply sigma Ma is equal to 0 here. Ra dash will be creating zero moment. Now 200 about A causing a moment like this clockwise. Therefore plus 200 into 25 about A, because this distance is 25. It is given here 25. Then 300 also creates clockwise moment about A. That is plus 300 into its distance from A is 50 meter. That is 300 into 50. Rb dash creates like this. It is anti-clockwise moment, therefore minus Rb dash into its distance of Rb dash from A. It is nothing but 100 meter. That is Rb dash into 100. From this equation, only one unknown, Rb dash, we can calculate 200 kilonewton. If you use this in equation number 1, Ra dash is 300 kilonewton due to external loading. Now, here, to find Ra double dash and Rb double dash, due to equivalent UDL, there is no need to go for equilibrium conditions. Because of symmetry, Ra double dash is equal to Rb double dash is equal to total load, that UDL. UDL This is UDL acting up, WE per meter, and this Rb double dash and Ra double dash. This is 100 meter. This WE is acting up. Therefore, this UDL is equivalent to an imaginary point load of magnitude is equal to W into WE into length over which it is distributed. Therefore, it is WE is the total load, WE into L is the total load. This total load will be transferred to this support and this support equally, therefore by 2. RB dash is equal to this, and that is also equal to RE dash. Now, we should take or you should apply sigma MC is equal to 0 for given loading and WE. That is, if you take combined girder or a girder at 50, and this is, that is RA dash 200 300, correct? Yeah, 200 and 300 kilonewton. RB dash we found 200 kilonewton, and RA dash we found 300 kilonewton. Now, because of this UDL, which is acting on the girder in the upward direction, that is equivalent to UDL. WE per meter. This is acting up, means the reaction here will be downward. Black color is for given loading. The reaction in this blue color is for equivalent UDL. That is WE into L by 2 is RB dash, and WE into L by 2 is RA dash equal. This is the combined diagram. Now, hinge C is here. Now, to find WE, we should apply sigma MC is equal to 0. We should consider, I think you have seen in the arches, if we are applying equilibrium condition for the middle hinge, we should consider left side or right side. Because if the whole is in equilibrium, the portion of the structure to the left of C or to the right of C also in equilibrium. Maybe an arch or maybe a beam here, a girder here. Sigma MC is equal to 0. Now you should decide which side we should apply. If you apply left side, RA dash, RA double dash, 200, and the UDL from ear to ear are responsible for the moment. If you consider left right side, RB double dash, and UDL is responsible. This UDL only. That means this 200 is extra if you consider left side. Therefore, if you want to reduce the calculation, by one quantity, we can consider right side sigma mc is equal to 0. If you apply sigma mc is equal to 0, now rb dash, I'll write here, rb dash about c this, okay, creates a moment like this. See, correct, it is anti-clockwise, therefore minus rb dash into its distance from here, it is 50, because ng set the middle, total span is 100, it is 50, rb dash into 50, then this rb double dash, if you take the moment of rb double dash about c, it is acting down and it causes a bending moment like this, moment like this about c, it is clockwise, therefore it is plus rb double dash into its distance is again 50, because they are collinear, they are acting at same point. And rb dash we know, wel by 2, we'll substitute that later. Then this we acting up about c, it is causing this udl is equivalent to an imaginary load of magnitude is equal to we into 50, we into 50, that is equivalent point load, this is only, or 100 by 2, whatever it is, because that much of udl only responsible for causing the moment at c, and this is acting like this, causing a moment like this about c, it will try to rotate the beam like this, it is anti-clockwise, that is minus we into 50 into its perpendicular distance is this equivalent point load, it is half of 50, that is 50 by 2, no other force equated to 0 for equilibrium. See here, rb dash this and rb double dash and this udl are responsible for the moment, and by equating it to 0, because c is an inch, from this rb dash we have calculated, and rb dash is 200 kilonewton. This is 200, and this rb double dash is we into l divided by 2. Combining this and this term and rearranging, we can calculate we, and it is 8 kilonewton per meter. 50% of the problem is over. That is what it is presented here, and W is 8 kilonewton per meter. Now it is asked to find bending moment and shear force at 30 meter from left end. For calculation of the bending moment, it is due to the given loading as well as the equivalent UDL. Now a pedi moment at 3 meter if you want. Here. 30 meter means some area. XX at 3 meter. At any section, XX bending moment is required. Now bending moment, we know it is the algebraic sum of the moments. Either to the left or right of the point or section considered. Now sign convention is sagging positive, hugging negative. Usually in a beam, upward forces create sagging, downward forces creates hugging. That should be due to both given loading and due to equivalent loading. Now bending moment at this section, if you consider left side bending moment, at 30 meter from left, I will consider left side. Any side you can consider, because if you consider left side, two reactions, 200 and UDL. If you consider right side also, two reactions, one point load and UDL. Here also point load, any side we can deal. I consider left side, sagging positive, hugging negative for this. Now to the left of this point, RA dash is upward. Therefore, it creates sagging bending moment. Remember, only point loads and UDL are there. Sign convention, upward sagging, downward hugging. Or from first principle, you can decide. RA dash is upward, sagging about this section, and its distance is 30 meter. That is RA dash into 30. Then RA double dash, it is acting down, therefore hugging, minus RA double dash into its distance, again 30. Then this 200, it is acting down, causes hugging, or it try to bend the beam in such a way that convexity upward, therefore minus. It is 200 into its distance from XX. Now this distance is 25 meter, it is given in the question. 200 is at 25 meter from left end. I want the moment or bending moment due to this 200 kilonewton about XX, means it is 30 minus 25, it is 5 meter. 200 into 5. Then this UDL, it is acting up, create or try to bend the girder like this, that is concavity upward, that means sagging plus, or it is upward force creates sagging. It is WE into length over which it is distributed about the section XX. The length of the UDL which is responsible for the bending moment is 30 only. Therefore, into 30, its perpendicular distance, we know this is equivalent to a point load of magnitude equal to WE into 30, because this is 30, length of the UDL, that is 30 into its distance will be mid length of that 30 means 30 by 2. That's equal to 0. See, Ra dash is due to the external loads. Rga double dash is due to equivalent UDL. 200 is the given loading. We is an equivalent UDL. And here Ra dash we know 300 kilonewton. Ra double dash is WE, that is 8 into L, that is 100 divided by 2. Here it is. It was written in terms of WE because at that stage we were not knowing WE. But now by applying sigma MC is equal to 0, WE was found and it is 8 kilonewton per meter. This will be 400, and here this W is H. All values are known. We can calculate the bending moment, and it is minus 400 kilonewton meter, and it is hugging. Negative means hugging. That is what it is presented in this 400 kilonewton meter. I have explained here also. Okay. Now coming to the shear force at the same section here. Shear force at this section. Shear force is the algebraic sum of the forces either to the left or right of the section considered. That means shear force at 30 meter is equal to, again, this is the section. We can calculate the shear force at this section by considering left side forces or right side forces. We have considered left side here. Here also let us consider left side. Now, to calculate the shear force, I take upward forces positive, downward forces negative. Therefore, it is plus Ra dash minus Ra double dash, it is acting down, 200, it is downward minus 200, and this UDL is acting up, therefore plus, and UDL is WE into 30. No perpendicular distance. Yeah, we were taking the moment, therefore again half of the length of the UDL. Here it is the algebraic sum of the forces. Equivalent point load to this UDL is intensity of UDL into length of the UDL. That's all. Ra dash we know 300. Ra double dash we know this one, and WE we know 8. If you calculate, you get the shear force at a distance 30 kilonewton, 30 meter from the left end, and it is 60 kilonewton. It means the shear force is negative. That is what it is presented here. 60 kilonewton, and it is downward. Bending moment and shear force should be calculated due to given loading as well as due to equivalent UDL on the girder. That is this. Okay. That is the analysis of the girder, which is extra in this stiffening girder or trusses in suspension cables. Now coming to the analysis of the cable. Analysis of the cable. It is as usual. VA will be equal to total load W into L divided by 2, that is 400 kilonewton, and it is equal to VB also. And applying sigma MC is equal to 0, here that is the bottommost point. MC is equal to 0. It is not an inch at every point in the cable. Bending moment is 0. Algebraic sum of the moment is 0. Therefore, because this 10 is known, therefore we are taken C, sigma MC is equal to 0. That is, by considering left side or right side, sigma MC, we can calculate the horizontal reaction. That is, H into H. Want an explanation? I have presented very briefly in the slide because we dealt so many problems in the arch. Sorry, in the cable. That is, cables, the reaction VA and HA, here HB and VB. The load acting is UDL, that is WE per meter, or it is 8 kilonewton per meter that we found. That is the UDL. Now this is the buttermost point C. It is not the inch. Now it is given, this is 10 meter, the maximum dip, and the span is 100 meter. This is the analysis of the cable. Now, if you apply sigma, H is equal to 0, HA will be equal to HV is equal to H. Sigma FY is equal to 0, that is VA plus VB is equal to total load. Total load is 8 into 100. That is 800. VA is equal to VB. Therefore, it is total load divided by 2. That is 400 kilonewton. Correct? Yeah, 400 kilonewton. Now, applying sigma MC is equal to 0. This we can consider left side or right side. Any side it will be similar. Let us consider left side. Now, this HA, the line of action of HA is this. That means about C, it is causing a moment like this. It is anticlockwise. Therefore, minus HA into its distance is 10 meter. This line of action is HA is here, its distance is 10 meter. Now VA. VA is causing a moment like this about C. It is clockwise. Therefore, plus VA into its distance is, the line of action of VA is here. The distance will be this. It is 100 by 2. That is 50. And UDL, which is acting down. This UDL, equivalent UDL, equivalent to a point load of magnitude equal to 8 into, it is up to C only. This UDL, because we are taking moment center as C. Therefore, 8 into 50 is an equivalent point load. And it is causing a moment like this about C, like this. Therefore, minus 8 into 50 is an equivalent point load, and its distance, its moment about C means this distance. It is 50 by 2. That is 25. You can write is equal to 0 for equilibrium. From this, HA we can calculate. That is, HA is equal to, if you calculate, you will get 1000 kilonewton. That's equal to HB, or that is equal to HA area. That is the analysis of the cable. What is asked in the cable is also the maximum tension and its slope in the cable. Maximum tension, we know. See na? Okay. Yeah. Maximum tension will occur here. Here. Other words, if you write an arch VA HA HB, VB. Now, maximum tension will be at this point. We know that T max we have analyzed, because at any other point other than the support, this T max will be less, or T will be lesser than T max, because VA or VB will go on decreases, unbalanced force. At any section. Therefore, this T max can be calculated. This is theta, as the resultant of this VA and HA. That is nothing but they are concurrent forces. Therefore, VA squared plus HA squared. We can calculate and we get VA squared plus HA squared. If you substitute VA and H, VA is 400, HA is 1000. We get this as 1077.03 kilonewton. And its inclination theta will be tan inverse of VA by HA. That will be equal to, oh sorry, not this, okay. This is in the resultant. At this point, T max if you apply sigma fx is equal to 0 here if you resolve t max horizontally, t max cos theta is equal to ha. Therefore, cos theta will be equal to ha divided by t max from this theta. Ha we know 100, t max we know this 1077.03. Therefore, theta can be calculated and it is 21.8 degrees. Further, any analysis if cable is passed over fully or connected to saddle, the analysis remains same. Now, that is one problem, stiffening girder. Analysis of girder and this should be done correctly and separately. Now coming to one more problem. So far I have not given any problem for homework or assignment. I give just instructions here or hint and try to solve according to the procedure we dealt. Now, a suspension bridge, 12 meter span, very smaller span, the length span is 120 meter. Sorry, this is 120 meters. Span has two 3-inch stiffening girder. One is this, another is on the other side. It is in elevation. In the cross section, there will be two girders supported by two cables. This is one cable, and on the other side, another cable. With a central dip of 12 meter, the roadway has a width of 6 meter. Oh. That is, in cross section, if we write it is like this, footpath, it is 6 meter. This here stiffening girder runs perpendicular to the board. This is stiffening girder. This is also stiffening girder. Now this is the cable. You can see points here. This is in cross section. This is what it is given here. This is in the longitudinal elevation or section. Girder, this is the girder. This girder, if you see in the cross section, we can see like the shape of the girder. Like this here. This is the footpath. 6 meter length or the roadway. Central dip is 12 meter. There are two cables, it was told already, don't get confused here. Two stiffening girder and this is the roadway. Now, the dead load on the bridge is 5 kilonewton per meter square. Oh, this.
dead load. While the lie load is 10 kilonewton per meter square, which acts on the left half of the span. Oh, only for this length. It is given in kilonewton per meter square. This is another small thing you should remember. Dead load is five kilonewton per meter square. Lie load is 10 kilonewton per meter square. That is here. Now this load here, dead load and lie load act here. That will be converted to an equivalent, that should be converted into equivalent UDL on the girder. Half the dead load will go to this girder and half the dead load will go to this girder. Therefore, this dead load equal to on any one girder, this is girder. This dead load should be converted into the lie load. Dead load should be converted per meter square, should be converted into UDL, and it is over a length of 6 meter. That means 5 into 6, that divided by 2. That means it will be 15 kilonewton per meter. That is, half the dead load will go to this girder, half the dead load will go to this later girder, and it will be in the form of UDL because square meter is converted into, this is 15 kilonewton per meter, should convert into equivalent UDL. Now coming to the lie load, it is said lie load acts only in the left half of the girder. Lie load acts in the left half of the girder. Wherever it acts, that lie load also per meter square, half the lie load will go to this girder, half the lie load will go to this girder. Therefore, again, this will be 10 into 6 by 2. That is 30 kilonewton per meter will act as UDL up to the midspan. That is 60 meter, the total is 120. And this is 30 kilonewton per meter, that is a UDL. Okay. This is the external load acting on the girder in the form of UDL, two UDLs. Therefore, now to analyze the girder, first, this is one more important point in this problem. UDL is not given directly, it is given as load per square meter, that should be converted into UDL like this. Half will go to this
half will go to this, that is 6 by 2. That is another very good point in this problem. Now, this analysis of girder. Girder, as like previous problem, should be analyzed for external loading and for equivalent UDL. Therefore, due to this external loading, dead load 15 kilonewton per meter and 30 kilonewton per meter, find RA dash and RB dash. Now, this girder analysis for equivalent point load, because it is connected by suspenders to the cable. Therefore, this UDL or cable will try to pull the girder up, or the load will act as upward UDL, that is WE per meter. Therefore, reactions will be downward, and let they are RA double dash and RB double dash. This is for given loading, and this is the free body diagram of the girder for WE. Now you should find WE. Now, as usual, by considering the equilibrium of this girder, find RA dash and RB dash because of this downward UDL. Full and plus this half should do carefully RA dash and RB dash. That is by applying sigma Fy is equal to 0 and sigma MA is equal to 0. We can find RA dash and RB dash. Here, RA double dash is equal to RB double dash, that is WE into 120 divided by 2, L by 2. Now then, by considering left side or right side, this sigma MC, if you consider right side, it will be better because this UDL can be avoided. If you consider right side, it will not exist here. Now for sigma MC, for loading, that is external given loading, and due to UDL, equivalent UDL, you should consider, and we can calculate WOE. Check the value of WOE, you get 30 kilonewton per meter. That's all the analysis of the girder. They didn't ask you to calculate shear force or bending moment. If it is asked, it can be calculated. Similarly, now next, by taking this load on the cable, equivalent UDL, this cable will be analyzed. They ask you to find maximum tension in the cable. It is absolute maximum tension will be here. Therefore, you should find VA and HA due to this WE, that what we have calculated, 30 kilonewton per meter. And maximum tension, H squared plus VA squared. And inclination of the T, if you want, T max is equal to T max cos theta will be equal to H. From that theta, you can find. Now that is this problem. Try to solve. And that is about arches and cables. I think almost all the type of problems that appeared in the university question paper have taken. Easy chapter. For do carefully, just if you understand the concept, almost some similarity is there between arches and cables, 3 inches confidently, you solve it. Now, if you want some more problems, you go to university question paper. Or what I find, this structural analysis by Reddy, a good book. If you find some good questions, good problems, you solve according to this procedure, because the sign convention used will be different. Don't get confused with the different sign convention used by different authors. Understand this concept. Take problems from any question paper or from any textbook. Solve according to that. Feel free to contact me if you have any doubts, because I have given my contact details also. Now with this, I will wind up. Thank you and wish you all the best. At this point, I thank the members of eSikshana VTU or VTU eLearning for giving me an opportunity for the second time to give online classes in this 18CV42. And I also thank Dr. Ramakrishna Gowda, Professor and HOD of Civil Engineering Department at MIT Mysore, for having confidence on me to allot this topic for online classes. Any of live classes I could not do because of this corona problem. And once again, thanking all those who have given opportunity to present this. And I wish the students all the best in the coming examination. Thank you. Thank you very much.